Alola, Pokemon Trainers, Professor Chaz here, the lab coat's on back order, and welcome back to our Pokemon Moon playthrough, episode number 64, coming up on noontime here in the Alola region. As you just saw, we had a bit of a grinding montage because, in the last episode, we basically finished up everything I wanted to do with the team I was using. I had Cordial and Prowl of our current trainees. I also had Tapu Koko, who we did manage to add to our collection several episodes back, and I also had... Well, Blaze wasn't there with us, but I had Blaze, Smarty the Noct Owl, Blaze the Charizard, I should say, Smarty the Noct Owl, Burrow the Ninjask, and Guar the Primeape. But we've accomplished everything with them for the time being. It's now time to check out another section of Pony Island, Pony Coast, and I have a new team working with us. And as you saw, we did have a grinding montage to get the current trainees kind of trained up a little bit, trying to get them on par with the wild Pokemon. So I guess we start things off with a team recap. No, you know what? I'm not done recapping what I did last time. So... what we did manage to accomplish was finishing up the Ultra Beast Hunt in Verdant Cavern. I keep calling it Cave. Looker and Annabelle from the International Police did send us in to deal with not one, not two, not three, not five, but four UB-02 beauties, also known as Pheromosa. And in two episodes ago, we caught two of them. We caught the other two in the last episode. Wait, spoilers. But yes, we caught all four of the Pheromosa. The mission was complete. And then we found out there's something else happening on Akala Island now. There's another Ultra Beast sighting there. But we're not quite ready for that yet. We're going to add some more power to the team. But before we do that, I am going to check out Pony Coast, getting us ever so closer to the battle tree at the end of Pony Island. So, as I said, there was a grinding montage. Let's do a team recap, see who we have on the team for the time being. We have, starting off, at level 60, our Palossand Icona, traded to me by my nephew. He is a serious Pokemon. Water compaction ability. Wait, yeah, serious is a neutral nature. Water compaction ability, sharply boosting defense when hit by a water move. Holding onto the citrus berry, he finally relinquished his hold on that Ghostium Z. You know what? I feel like giving it back to him. That's been his, it's almost like his teddy bear Lucky Charm item this whole time. I'll give it back. Anyway, Earth Power, Shadow Ball, Giga Drain, and Shore Up for the moves. Next we have the one and only Nebby. Yes, our Lunala is here. Nebby at level 60 is a bold Pokemon, defense up and attack down, which isn't terribly too bad. Look at the special defense being already higher than physical. How's the training going? All right. And obviously he's more, or I should say it's more because there's no gender, but it's Lily referred to Nebby as a he throughout the playthrough, so Nebby's a he to me. Even though from what I'm told, it's believed that the male Cosmog would evolve into Solgaleo while female evolve into Nebby, but whatever, I don't really know. Nebby has really good special attack. Physical attack is not super good, so losing that stat's not the worst thing. And trying to boost up the lesser defense is actually a pretty decent thing. Anyway, the ability Shadow Shield will... how does it do? It reduces damage when you're at full HP. Exactly what I just said right there. Holding on to Colbur Berry because he is double weak to dark, and we were dealing with some training against Pokemon such as Gumshoes, which might have known Crunch, and some other dark type moves could have been a problem. So I thought, you know what? Let's hold the Colbur Berry just for defensive purposes. And moveset is Moonbeist Geem. No, it's actually Moongeist Beam. Did you know that? Plus he has Nightshade. Why can't I speak? Moongeist Beam, Night Daze, Cosmic Power, and Moonlight. Moving on. Now, those are the two current trainees, four returning champions from previous generations, starting off with Dozer, our female Snorlax. I do have two Snorlax in my collection. Dozer is a naive Pokemon with a speed boost and special defense drop. Not really the best nature, because Snorlax are not known for speed. Look at the hexagon, as you can see on the top screen. That's not even a hexagon. That's almost like a pentagon, more or less. Anyway. The ability is immunity, preventing getting poisoned. Holding the Normalium Z, because we're going to probably focus on using the level 100s for this episode, trying to show off some of their Z moves. I wonder what Z Metronome would do. We'll have to try that out. Anyway, the moveset is Bulldoze, Rock Tomb, Metronome, and Yawn. Next, we have Stinger, our Beedrill, and it's kind of funny. I randomly determined which Pokemon I'm going to be using at which point in time for each main, you know, post-game section of this adventure, and I've been talking a lot about Beedrill and Mega Beedrill on the channel lately. What are the odds that Stinger was randomly chosen to be one of the Pokemon? Anyway, he is a hasty Pokemon, as you can see there, which is really pretty decent. Speed up and defense down, and it turns out he has almost max IVs in speed. I believe he is only 4 points below what he could have for maximum speed because of his IVs. You'll see I've got him maxed out in attack and speed stat. And he's almost there at maximum speed. I love that. Anyway, the ability is Swarm, boosting bug moves in a pinch. Holding onto the Ground EMZ to allow for... what is that move? What is that move? I forget the name of the attack. It's the one that launches things into the Earth's core, essentially. But anyway, he has False Swipe, Twin Needle, Drill Run, and Endure. Normally he has Poison Jab, but I gave him False Swipe in case we find any special Pokemon at some point. But moving on, we have Gary, our first Gyarados. I do have two Gyarados in my overall collection. But Gary is... what's that nature? Naive Nature. Wait, we already have a Naive Pokemon right there. Anyway, Naive Gary the Gyarados, level 100. Intimidate ability and holding the Dragonium Z... which would, I don't even know what Z Dragon Dance would do, but we'll probably find out. Well, moveset is Waterfall, Earthquake, Crunch, and Dragon Dance, and our last Pokemon right now. Although it's a Kanto species, this is Cliff, our Clefairy, from the Sinnoh region. We haven't seen that playthrough yet, but Cliff is a timid Pokemon, upping speed while dropping attack, Magic Guard ability preventing any... basically, will only take HP loss from direct hits. Things like Weather, Poison, or Burn do not take HP away from him. Even Leech Seed has no effect on him. Holding the Psychium Z to allow for Z Trick or Z Reflect. He also has Metronome and Helping Hand. Now then, let's move on. Usually I'll use Cliff as a Flame Orb holder, and he'll trick the item onto the opponent. Of course, in this day and age of Z Crystals and Mega Stones, that's not as good a technique as it used to be. So this is a whole new area. I have no idea what we're going to find here on the Pony Coast. Maybe some more berry trees, maybe something for Tauros to smash, maybe a TM. Nothing in that rock. All right then. So let's see what there is to find. Bear with me as I get a little bit quiet because I want to sort of explore around and focus on anything that I... well, I don't want to... I want to focus on anything that I might be missing. Hello, Firo. That was an electrifying shot. Look at that. Okay, now face my way. Turn around. You're not going to turn around, are you? You're getting some good sounds from Rotom, though. That almost looks like a Ho-Oh flying from the back. Did you see that? Oh, this is perfect. Oh, come on. I should have taken the shot when I had the chance. Turn around just once, please. Please, there we go. I'm going to say that was perfect. All right. Let's see which one was the best. I'm thinking the last one was... I don't know. I kind of like that one, the way the wings are a little arced down. I'm going to go with that one. We'll show that off to the world, see what we get for thumbs ups. Let's see. Looking at it from this angle isn't bad either. It's a good shot, like anyone can take. Thanks! Just like Alola, but also kind of different. I'll be your fan from now on. Alright, I'll take that. Ooh, 3,000 thumbs ups. Not bad. So I'm at 25,000. I need 100,000. I'm a quarter of the way there to get to version 4. That's quite a little ways to go. I didn't know this, but I think you can go and... like, I could take another photo right now and add more thumbs ups. I might start doing that off camera to get some more... use the camera off camera to get more thumbs ups just to sort of see if I can, you know, advance things along there. But I'm not going to do too much of that on camera. We want to see more story if possible. So is there anything even on the Pony Coast? Because it doesn't seem to be like a lot of stuff. There's TM here. I'm going to try and grab that for myself. Now what would that one be? It is Dark Pulse. I will take that. Is there anything else we found up here? Doesn't look like it. So down we go. There's really not much here, is there? I thought there'd be some trainers or something. Well, if we can just get through Pony Coast quite quickly and easily, I'd be okay with that. Another Zygarde cell. It's mine. Wait, out of the way. I want that Zygarde cell. No, I'm not going to get attacked by that Pokemon. I'm going to be able to run away in time. Watch this. Speed boost. Uh-oh. Whatever. I want to fight it anyway. I want to see what this is. What would be digging through the dirt here in this little canyon? Are you surprised? I'm not surprised. But I want to get a battle going on. I want to start bringing in some older Pokemon and see what their Z attacks look like. Icona, we're going to get you out of here. I don't think this thing has Arena Trap. Does Arena Trap affect ghost types? I don't know. So in comes Dozer. We could bulldoze this thing. Hey, wait a minute. Maybe that's why I taught her Bulldoze. I named her Dozer because we already had Snoozer the Snorlax. Dozer kind of fits too, because if you're asleep, you're dozing off, you're snoring, or snoozing, whatever. So, but Bulldoze makes sense for Dozer. Alright, so Z Power. We have Z Metronome. The user waggles a finger and stimulates its brain into randomly using nearly any move. Doesn't say there's anything specific about it. Z Yawn. I didn't want to use it! I just wasted the Z move! I wanted to hit the eye. Alright then. Now, what does it do here? I should say. Boosted the speed. First, it avoids the attack. Well, are we faster than it now? I doubt it. But let's see if Bulldoze will hit you underground. Doesn't matter. You're going to come up anyway. Even after our speed-boosting nature and the speed boost of the Z-Yawn, you're still faster? Yeah, we are a Snorlax. I wanted to see what the Z-Metronome would have done, though. I wanted to use that one. All right, Dozer needs some care. He must have got a little bit muddy. No, a little bit dusty. Now, isn't it cool? This really doesn't look right on the layout, the way the two screens are, but you got a two-screen Pokemon here. In fact, let me show you something. I don't know if I showed this off yet. I'm going to show you what Nebby the Lunala looks like here. Because not only does Nebby take up both screens, look how slow the game lags when all of Nebby is on screen. See, I'm going to try to pet Nebby. Scroll up, please. Even this is kind of slow. Look how slow that goes. You're too big for your own good, Nebby. You should have stayed as a Cosmo. No, I'm just kidding. I like Lunala. Alright, so we didn't get to see the Z-Metronome. I believe if we don't get to see it, then... Oh, wait a minute. We got a double battle coming up. If we don't get to see it, then I think what it does, you get to, like, you don't get to choose. It basically randomly chooses any Z attack, and you use that one. Star Piece, that's good for some cash. Now, is there anything else? Oh, wait, this takes us to the gauntlet. Not quite ready for... Oh, it's that girl! What's her name again? Painter Lady. Nina, that's it. Oh, you're the one from the Great Composition. I just did 100 sketches, so now I'm taking a break. I beat all the trainers around here, too, so now I'm totally bored again. I wish there was someone to go all out against. That's it. Chaz, if you can beat all the trainers around here, too, I'll give you a battle against me. Well, we're going to save this for a different team of Pokemon. Instead, we're going to come up here, deal with these two trainers. Another item. Hang on. I'm going to see if I can bust that rock again and get one more item. I wonder if there's certain items that always provide an... certain rocks that always provide an item. Let's see. I was wrong. But this gives us a chance... Oh, come on. To make up for what I just did, I messed up. I'm going to go deal with that Dugtrio again. I want to see Z-Metronome in action. Come on. What should be a different Pokemon now? Not that it really matters. I'm still going to use the move. It is a Dugtrio. Remember when that thing was first revealed in the demo? I didn't know what to make of it. And I thought, what kind of typing could they do with that? Who would have known they would have said that the hair has become steel type? Or at least makes it a steel type. Alright, Dozer, get back in here. I'm going to activate Z-Move. I'll probably just hit L and A to bring up the info on Z-Yawn. No, we didn't even... I think that's Fisher? Anyway, we don't even need to see what Z-Yawn does. We know it boosts your speed. Alright, let's just go Z-Power, Z-Metronome. Stop trying Fisher. We're like twice your level. Alright. What happens here? Full force Z move. So Z... Oh. Okay, so that's what it does. It'll still randomly choose any attack, but it makes it the Z variant of that attack. Now that we know that... Out of the way, Dugtrio. Stop trying Fisher! Why? Go away! Alright, let's deal with those two trainers. So I'm going to lead with my two current trainee Pokemon, but I'll be swapping one of them out, maybe both, into one of the level 100s. So we'll take a look at what kind of Z-move that they have to work with. Look at all this dust already. And as I take care of Dozer, I'm going to... Well, I have one of my little topics of discussion. People are being mean to me in Pokemon TCG Online. And by that I mean, I've set up trades to get some of the Pokemon GX, because I want to make videos for you folks out there, focusing on the Pokemon GX and the new Sun and Moon set. No one's trading them to me. I'm trying to get like three Decidueye GX for a cool deck idea that I have, but I can't seem to get enough of the cards because people... I understand, people want to keep them. They're new, they're fresh, they're amazing. They're too good to give up. But let me have them for the videos. I'll give them back, maybe, eventually. I'm not just an ordinary sightseer. We want even stronger rivals. My Pokemon and I both cry out for that. So, sightseers are going to have Kanto form Pokemon, I would expect. Sightseer duo, or honeymooners, Noriko and Devin. They look at their phones, ready for some selfies there. Ninetales and Sandslash. Oh, so we met two trainers, ace trainers, in, was it the Vast Pony Canyon? With the Alola forms of these two. Oh, this is going to slow things down a lot with Nebby on the field. So that being the case, you know what? I'm actually going to switch both Pokemon out. Let's switch into Stinger. And we'll bring in Gary as well. I don't know if Gary's going to make things too slow or whatever, but we'll switch them out. We'll go with... I think Stinger will make use the Z move. Yeah, because he's going to have the Groundium Z to go for. What is the name of that attack again? Seismic something? I think it's Seismic something. Don't burn my Beedrill. Get out of here. And Gyro Ball doing nothing. I like how that looks, though. Alright, before I click the Z move, I want to remember Seismic. No, I was way off. Tectonic Rage, alright. That is super effective on the Ninetales. And Gary, let's just go ahead and fire off a Waterfall on the Sandslash, because we can't use your Z Dragon Dance. Here we go. Stinger, our Beedrill, the first Z move he's being given, or being used. No, the first Z move he's using in Gen 7 is the Tectonic Rage. Let's watch him fire this off. Whoa! You'd think that wouldn't hurt a Ninetales as much, because it went into the fire, but the ground part certainly hurts it quite a bit. Down it goes, time... Oh wait, these trainers have two Pokemon, don't they, I think? They do, right. I saw that on the beginning part. And down goes their first two. Now what are we going to see? More Kanto forms, I would expect. Leveling up for Icona. No, for Nebby just yet. And a standard Exeggutor that is super weak to bug. And a Golem that is super weak to water. Alright then. So, I'm expecting that I've already seen every Alola form that there is. Because we're seeing... Like, whenever you see a Sightseer like this, they pretty much are using whatever Alola forms that there would be. Except they're using their standard form, like, you know, from Kanto or Johto, wherever they come from. Sturdy? Sturdy. Don't blow up. That's gonna hurt. Stinger, you got this, though. I didn't want to make a layout change, stupid Golem. Alright, then. What should we do? Oh, I'm just gonna have Gary destroy it anyway. Nebby, come on in here. Slow things down a bit. Alright, we'll add a injury counter to Stinger. But again, being level 100, he's okay. He'll be back momentarily. As we go for a nice, nice, nice powerful... No, you know what? Let's just crunch. Why not? Down goes Golem. I'll grab myself a revive for poor Stinger, who did not need a Stone Edge to the face. Thank you, Golem. Thank you for showing the strength I was looking for. I'm glad I came to Alola. Whoa, I discovered a cluster of talent in the Alola region. That is me. I am the champion, after all. I'm a sightseer battling to get stronger in the battle facilities of each region. Good luck with all that. Battle towers are... That's right. Battle tower... Speak right, Professor. That's right. Battle towers and their like in distant regions are the facilities I favor. I do appreciate challenge, but as I've said this before, Battle Tower goes a little bit overboard with the challenge, I'm going to say, because of how, you know, how random the luck seems to be more on the computer side than it is on the player side. Alright, Stinger is back up and ready to roll again there. So he's used his Z-move. We've got to see what Gary's Z-move is going to be like next. But there's no more trainers to fight. Ooh, Comet Shard, that's a lot of good cash. So we can't go anywhere else here. So the only thing left is the Gauntlet. I'm just going to tap on the map here, as you can see. Zooming in. The Gauntlet is right up here. And then we head over to the battle tree at the very end. So that's going to be what the next team goes through. So I guess with that, we are done on the coast. I wasn't sure how long this was going to take, but apparently it's only very short. Since we're here, let me just... I want to see what the Z-moves are like before moving on from here. I'm going to go and encounter another one of those wild Dugtrio. Because Or you know what? Does it always appear? I hear it. Hang on. Was that the water? Nope, there it is. All right. We'll encounter this one, then I'll head back down to the Pony Plains, get one encounter there, and see what one of Cliff's Z-moves are going to be like. I want to show off each Pokemon, like the previous Pokemon Z-moves, before kind of not using them again. Although, I'm going to be using them when we go after the next Tapu, which is going to be this episode because of how Pony Coast was so short. And I got to switch Icona out of the lead. He actually leveled up. Nebby needs the next level. So we're going to go to Gary, see what Z-Dragon Dance does. So, regular Dragon Dance boosts your attack and your speed. Wonder what... Well, Dig's gonna do nothing. So, what will the Z-Dragon Dance have in store? Gallon A is... We reset stats first, and then boost your attack and speed. Okay. Let's just use it. Let's go, Gary. Z-Dragon Dance! Whoa! I haven't even seen that move yet, because, yeah... We got the Dragonium Z from not like a trial captain. So we didn't get to see anyone use the move yet. Looks pretty cool, like to get the nice shape of the teeth for your hands there. Alright, Dig does nothing. Let us... Do we even need to knock... Yeah, Iconic can get some experience. Like I say, do we need to knock you out? Not really. Don't Tangling Hair me! Thank you. Not that it matters, because of course you are knocked out. So, Nebby! Take the lead. We'll go down to the Pony Coast, or Pony Plains. And, not Bag, I want the Pokemon. And we'll see what... I guess we can try Z-Metronome again. No, wait, we got the Psychinium Z on Cliff. So Z-Reflect or Z-Trick? Wait a minute, can you even use Z-Trick? You shouldn't be able to, I don't think the Z-Crystal is movable like that, is it? I doubt it. We'll find out though. Let's jump into a random battle, and that's going to be... Da-da-da-da! A Petalil. A little tiny Pokemon. Not bad, because we're going to send in our little tiny Pokemon as well. Cliff would be the smallest on the team right now, I think. So let's switch around into our Clefairy. And we'll just see what Z-Trick has to say. It should... What if it actually just says, this attack fails? Because it doesn't really make sense, right? Alright, Z-Power. So, Z-Trick. Our speed goes up twice. The user catches the target off-guard and swaps its held on with its own. I want to kind of see that, but let me see what Z-Reflect says. Defense goes up. Alright, so we get the half damage reduction from the Reflect itself, plus our physical defense goes up by one. Let me just see what Z-Trick does. Because I can't imagine we're going to give the item to the Petalil. Boosted speed sharply using Z-Power. Unleashes the full force Z-move, but it failed. Alright, so... It's kind of weird they gave a Z-variant to a move that normally would not do anything, right? My Magic Guard is gone! No! Alright, let's see what Metronome brings us. I love... Like, Metronome is one of my favorite attacks in the entire game. That's actually a pretty interesting question I can ask you. First impression, come on! Do you have a favorite attack in Pokemon? Be it either in the video game or in the TCG. And what is it? I really like Metronome because I love randomness. In a Nuzlocke kind of a thing, maybe not so much. But, see look, who would ever think to use Worry Seed on a Petalil? You know? And if this thing uses Entrainment now, it's gonna give me Insomnia. Do it, I wanna see that. No! So, I love the randomness of Metronome. You never know what you're going to get with it. It's like a box of chocolates, you know? See, look. Why would you even bother substituting on a Petalil? Cliff, you got one more chance to get a whopper of an attack with this Metronome. After that, we're going to be on our way. We got some stuff to take care of. Last chance for Metronome. Don't explode. I've had one layout change already. I don't want another one. Imprison. No more using your own Metronome against us there, Petalil. Alright, we're just gonna walk away. That's the one downside to Cliff. I could teach him something like Dazzling Gleam, but, like, some of these moves he has, he can't relearn, and I don't want to replace them, not be able to get them back ever again, so he's gonna keep what he has. But let's go here to Coney City, because Akala Island, I don't know if I mentioned this last time, but Looker and Annabelle told us, or rather Looker came running in and told us, that Akala Island is now under siege by an Ultra Beast. So what we want to do is call upon the assistance of the guardian of Akala Island, that is Tapu Lele, which we have not yet met. So if we can add Tapu Lele to the team, we're going to use it to help us defend its own island against the Ultra Beast incursion. So off to the ruins of life we go. I'm going to lead... I do have False Swipe on Stinger. And I've got Yawn on Dozer. So Stinger is going to lead for the False Swipe. I can switch into Dozer and go for the Yawn. Sleep is one of the better conditions for catching a Pokemon, I believe. I said this back when I was trying to go for Tapu Koko. I think Freeze is the best. It gives you the best modifier for your capture. But Sleep is one of the next best ones, I think. I'm not sure exactly if that's right, though. Burn and Poison, I know, make them easier to catch as well, but those are the pretty risky ones, because you're going to be continuously whittling their HP away. Alright, we need Machamp to push. Nope, we already did this. Machamp has already done its job here. I'm just going to stroll on in, see if we can recruit Tapu Lele. Throw a like down below, folks. Wish us luck for this, if it's even going to show up. So mysterious, so quiet. Reach out and touch the statue. Tapu Lele! Yep, here it is. I like this music. If you notice, there's a part of this song... Look at this! I've already seen it. But there's a part of the song that sounds like the Kahuna Trial music. Alright, so it is Fairy Psychic, which means it could hurt Stinger pretty bad. The battlefield got weird. I love the way that sounds. I hope this thing doesn't have anything that can hurt itself. Let's False Swipe away. We resist the Moonblast. Alright. Let's keep False Swiping until we get it down. If you want to get a critical Stinger, that would be amazing right about now. No criticals. So that will hurt. That's going to be boosted by the Psychic Terrain too. Okay. Calm down. Ease up there, Tapu Lele. Let's go for a nice, delicious old Max Potion for Stinger. He could dodge. He does still have Max Affection in Pokemon Refresh, thanks to carrying over from Pokemon Ami back in Gen 6. Don't do that. That's half my HP gone. Do I risk it? I'm going to risk it. I'm going to go for the False Swipe right now. You could dodge the Extra Sensory. And instead, they go for Nature's Magic, which I thought they might have done as well. It's only going to do half of my current HP, which is totally fine. All right, let's switch out into Dozer now. So we've seen Extra Sensory, Moonblast, Nature's Madness. You're a Psychic type. Don't have Recover. Dozer hits the field. Another Moonblast. All right, you can lower my attack if you like. We ain't going to be hitting you anytime soon. There it is. So the battlefield is no longer weird. I love that. The weirdness disappeared from the battlefield. So, Yawn away. So, I haven't seen your fourth move yet. What did Tapu Koko have? Agility, Electro Ball, Discharge, and Nature's Madness. It wouldn't have any of the electric moves. Maybe it would have Agility? So, let's just... You know what? Let's take a moment to heal up Stinger. Let's go for a Hyper Potion, I think, right now. Actually, a Hyper Potion barely does anything for him. That's dodging that Nature's Madness. Alright, to sleep it goes. Now we start chucking the Pokeballs. I should have stocked up again. I think 43 should be plenty to capture Tapu Lele, though. What do you guys think? Keep a track. There's Pokeball number one. Well then. You're gonna be like that, are you? You know, I kind of feel like... If I go below 30 Pokeballs, I'm going to try something. I'm thinking of trying a Quick Ball. The reason is the Psychic Terrain that Tapu Lele puts up prevents all priority moves from being used. How taunting would it be for Tapu Lele to be in a Quick Ball, taunting the opponents that, you know, you can't be quick against me because of the Psychic Terrain. But anyway, let's wait and see if a regular Pokeball does the trick. So far, none of them are. They're not even wobbling once. And it wakes up. And it goes for Extra Sensory. Just don't have anything like Takedown or anything. That'd be just brutal. You know, at 1 HP, you'd knock yourself out. So let's go for Yawn once again. Flatter. All right, that is perfect. Although you do confuse me. So it's not super perfect. But let's get the Yawn. Yes! Oh. Huh. That ain't no good. But I could full heal. I could full restore. Dodging those Nature's Madnesses is once again. I've heard that they have nerfed the chance to hurt yourself in confusion. So please stop that, Dozer. So another Moonblast. Actually, lower my attack again. I'll hurt myself less. So, I didn't realize that Tapu Lele's ability is the ability that causes the opponent to constantly hit themselves in confusion. Did you know that? It's news to me. So extra sensory, not going to knock me out because that's just not nice. And we're going to break through this time. Yes, Yawn. Let's go with a max potion. Get Dozer back up. She can take these hits for sure. There we go. Actually, I guess the hyper potion didn't do too bad for Stinger. But Dozer is our focus right now. Max potion it up. Is there anything else I could talk about while we're waiting for the Pokeball to finally click? I suppose I could say, recently I was talking about how I've been having some pretty bad leg pain. It was to the point that it was really hurting for me to walk around. It was really hindering my Pokemon Go, I'll tell you that much. But it actually is feeling a lot better now. Still not exactly 100% back to normal, but it no longer hurts to, like, you know, crouch, walk around. There's still a bit of, like, tenseness and tightness in the back, but it's a lot better than it was, so I'm quite happy to say I am recovering quite nicely from whatever happened. I might have slept on it wrong, I don't know, slept weird, causing it to, like, just do whatever legs do. It might have been something to do with, like, my lower back, too, because I woke up one day with a really bad lower back pain, which eventually spread down into the leg during the day. Come on! I can't ramble anymore, Tapu Lele. Stay in the ball! I know we've only been fighting you for, what has it been, like, 5 minutes? I don't know. Okay, Pokeball number, 38 remaining. Who hasn't hit the like button yet? As I said before, I believe, you're hitting the like button at this point in time if you're watching this, transfers back to the point that I recorded this and gives me better luck. Did you know that? All right, let's go with the Yawn attack. We have to break through confusion this time. We hit ourselves 3 times in a row last time. Ow. That's way too much power. Yes, Yawn. So actually, while they spend a turn being drowsy and then falling asleep at the end, I can heal. Do I want to go with, a hyper potion is not going to really do anything. It gets us to 250. But nah, we got max potions. Let's go with that. I can buy more. I can just keep smashing rocks and finding more stardust and star pieces as well. And going around, maybe stealing some wild pearls from... I was going to say, from Wild Shelter. But you could actually just find pearls by fishing in, you know, any fishing spot. Alright, back to sleep it goes. Tapu Lele, please, we need you to help us deal with the Ultra Beast of your island. Join with me, and together we can rule the galaxy as... No, wait, that was someone else. But join with me anyway. We can protect Akala together. I'm here for you. You gotta be here for me. Tapu Koko has already joined us. You must join us too. Doesn't that sound ominous? All guardians must join together. Plus, I want to see you use the Guardian of Alola attack. Stay in the ball! Now, I could use a different kind of Pokeball. But as you know me... I love the basic classic red and white Pokeball. For like the longest time, that's all you ever saw in the anime. Until, was it? I think it might have even been until they meet Kurt. Like, Ultra Balls and Great Balls were in the anime from the get-go. Not in the anime, they're in the video games from the get-go. How often did you see any trainers in the game, or in the anime, with a Great Ball or an Ultra Ball? You know, I didn't even know what they looked like. I remember back when I was writing my Pokemon stories, there's a part where you go on the SSN in-game, and you find a Great Ball in a garbage can. So, in my stories, I just wrote that it looked like a green Pokeball, because if you remember back to the Pokemon Blue playthrough, when you would play, what do I want to use? I'm going to full heal. Where is it? I'm going to go with a... Where are the full heals? There they are. Just to get rid of the confusion. Or did we break out? We already broke out, and now we're confused again! Anyway. The layout for, I believe it was like the Game Boy Color, or Super Game Boy, or whatever it was, on Pokemon Blue, it showed red Pokeballs, blue Pokeballs, and green Pokeballs. So that, I figured, meant that those were the other colors or other types of Pokeballs, like Great Ball and Ultra Ball. I wasn't sure which one was which, but I just decided to say, let's just say the Great Ball is green because they both start with G, right? As it turns out, no, Great Ball is blue with nice little red ridges. I didn't know that. All right, let's chuck one more red and white Pokeball. But yeah, you never saw them in the anime. I mean, to this day, have we ever seen an anime trainer use a Great Ball or an Ultra Ball? I can't even remember. I haven't seen every episode of the anime, of course. There are quite a number of them. All right, we're down to 6 yawns left. But I have plenty of Lepiberries, though. I can get as many yawns back as I need to deal with this encounter. I'm just concerned eventually this thing might knock itself out. So let's try something a little bit different. Let's throw a Pokeball while it's awake. Kind of mix things up a bit, confuse it. Render it shocked to be unable... Okay. Moonblast. And bop! Attacks that go down again, maybe? Does that always cause it? I don't think so. Anyway, another topic of discussion that IceKing688 had left at some point was, well, I already started talking about this a bit in the last episode, but favorite Pokemon and least favorite Pokemon of each type. I would say my least favorite Psychic and Fairy type might be the ones that don't stay in Pokeballs. So we are below 30. This is the worst time to go for a quick ball, but I'm going to try it anyway. Just to see what happens. Unless you want to stay in that Pokeball. Didn't think so. Stop faking me out like that. We need these Pokeballs for the Ultra Beasts, too. Alright, let's try the Quick Ball. Where is it at? We can also try... Okay. I'm going to try 3 Quick Balls. We'll see what happens here. If these 3 don't work, I'm going to try the Fast Ball. That's one. Go for the second one in a moment. Stop waking up. Because, again, the fastball sort of fits into the whole thing where you can't outspeed with speed priority on Tapu Lele because the psychic terrain is going to mess that up. It's going to be too weird. We're going to dodge that nature's madness. Come on! Put this thing to sleep. It's going to run out of PP at some point soon, too. And I'm going to run out of recording space. If you don't stay in the ball. Look how it shrinks you down. That's crazy looking. Really? So, they didn't nerf confusion at all, I'm gonna say. Alright, max potion. Once again, we're at 8 remaining. 7 now after using this one. Just fall asleep. Stay in the ball. And we'll be done here. And then we can go on and deal with whatever UB03 might be attacking Akala Island. Alright, yawn. I'm sure that's what you are all doing out there right now, watching me use standard basic Pokeballs to catch this thing. Yawn. But we get the yawn off now. Let's just try a Pokeball now, a regular one, not a quick ball. Right there, alright, so we'll try that. Once it's asleep, I'll try the second of the 3 quick balls I plan to use, and then we'll give that fastball a try. That's understandable, you're not asleep. I wonder if they're gonna... Here's an idea. So, with the online competition announcing that they're giving out Megastones, I wonder if they're gonna give out special Pokeballs as online competition prizes as well, because that'd be pretty cool. Alright, Quick Ball. Number 2. Plus the global missions, too, you can get the special Pokeballs. I like the fact that you're gonna be able to get a Friend Ball if we meet the... Is it 4,000 trades? But in a Quick Ball, we get... Tapu Lele. I kind of wanted to get that in the fastball. How unique would that have been? Very risky, though. But Tapu Lele has been added to our collection. Added to our team of warriors against the Ultra Beasts. So, 2 of 4 collected.
Registered a Land Spirit Pokemon. If I were you, I'd check it out at once. Tapu Lele, the Land Spirit Pokemon. Psychic Fairy. As it flutters about, it scatters its strangely glowing scales. Touching them is said to restore good health on the spot. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to go to sunandmoon.com and read about what it says. Just one second here. I'm going to do that right now. As we check out the actions. Okay, Google. PokemonSunMoon.com. I think this will work.
Whoa, look at that attack. Doesn't it look like Tapu Lele's sort of like in the Eggomatic? If you don't know what I'm talking about, play more Sonic the Hedgehog. And that's when it's firing off some sort of distance attack, it looks like. Alright, where are the Tapus? Let me check the... I'm wasting so much time here, but go to Pokemon. Wonder where your habitat is. Of course there's no habitat. Alright, let's go to Legendary. What? That's not Legendaries. Well, it is, but... Alright, let's go to all. And let's find Tapu Lele. Way at the bottom of the list, isn't it? Yes, it is gonna be. Bear with me, everybody. I know this is so riveting and so exciting. But I like to give Tapu Lele a nickname? Not at all. Where the heck is it? I see Tapu Koko. There it is, alright. So, Tapu Lele, as it said on the website, there's a legend which says that long ago, Tapu Lele once brought an end to war between the islands of Alola by scattering its scales and soothing the tired warriors. Tapu Lele scatters glowing scales that physically affect others, providing stimulation to their bodies and healing their illnesses or injuries. But these scales can be dangerous as well, because a body can't withstand the changes brought about by contact with too many scales at the same time. It will scatter its scales over humans and Pokemon for its own enjoyment. While it is innocent in one sense, there's also cruelty in the way it casually brings others to ruin. Our hero, everybody. The hero of Akala Island, the Guardian, against UB-03, which we know is Lightning. If Tapu Lele doesn't have much energy stored in its shell, it may lack the strength to seize victory in a head-on battle. With this in mind, it tends to prioritize not losing a battle over actually beating a foe, and it's skilled at strategies such as inflicting status conditions on its opponents, like the Flatter attack. So there's the Nature's Madness, the ability of Psychic Surge, yada yada yada. So I think what I'll do next time we go in against the Tapu, I'm going to read about it first, give you a little bit of backstory into it. So we aren't going to nickname you. We'll put you right in the party, because we're going to take you right after the Ultra Beast. So who do we want to swap out? Given the fact that we're going up against something lone as Lightning, I'm going to say probably our least likely Pokemon to be useful is going to be Gary. Our Gyarados. We'll put him in the PC. We'll remove the Dragonium Z. Not that it matters, we can put it on other Pokemon as well. So we can check out Tapu Lele right now. There is no reaction from the statue. So let's see what Tapu Lele has as far as nature and such. 1 HP, asleep. Alright, we gotta get you healed up, of course. So Tapu Lele is a hardy Pokemon, takes plenty of siestas. Hardy is a neutral nature. Alright, so nothing being lost. Nothing, no beneficial stat being dropped because of the nature, which is okay. Nature's Madness, Extrasensory, Flatter, and... Why is Flatter dark? And Moonblast, and of course the ability is Psychic Surge. So let us head on out of here and get the team healed up. And in the next episode, we're going to head off to route number, was it 8, I think? Where Looker and Annabelle have set up a temporary... Oh, I got to run through here. I was going to fly right away. They set up a temporary command center at the motel where Gladion was staying at, actually, interestingly enough. And we'll go from there to deal with the last of the Ultra... Not the... Why am I saying last? The last of the Ultra Beasts for this week, I meant to say. Because, of course, the next episode will be tomorrow on Friday. And who knows what's going to happen with UB-03 Lightning. So, as we go to heal up at the Pokemon Center, I want to say thank you everybody for watching today's episode of Pokemon Moon. Feel free to drop a like down below if you enjoyed it, and leave a comment letting me know what you thought, what you're looking forward to in the future of the playthrough, whatever, however much there is left to this. I don't even know how much more post-game there is, but we're moving along quite nicely. And if there's any other topic of discussion you want me to talk about, despite the fact that IceKing688 left me a good number of topics and I have barely even scratched the surface on them, feel free to leave those down below as well. I can talk about them in future episodes. And if you missed any episodes, excuse me, if you've missed any episodes of Pokemon Moon so far, there's a link in the description to the entire playlist. You can go and check that out and get caught up on all the adventures thus far. It's funny, I was talking to my friend John about, well, back in episode 49, he was saying, I hope you don't lose anyone during your grinding, and he was asking me, what episode was that? I had to scroll back in the playlist to see, and I thought, that was 49, here we are, episode 64 I'm recording. There's a lot to this game, and I love it. But if you missed anything, of course, there is that link in the description. Stay tuned to the outro for some links to some other videos that I have done, as well as a link to subscribe to the channel for more daily Pokemon content, including, hopefully, Pokemon GX custom decks in Pokemon TCG Online, if I can get the cards I need for them. But of course, there's also Pokemon Moon. On the weekend, we got a Pokemon Sapphire playthrough on the go, and I have Pokemon news update video thingies every week, on Mondays usually. And something I gotta do, I gotta teach Pikachu Volt Tackle and use Catastropica. We'll do that as a special feature at some point. I have an idea when I can sort of bring back older teams more consistently. But all that being said, we are now done for today. I want to say once again, thanks for checking out today's episode of Pokémon Moon. Professor Chaz is now signing off. I'll catch you next time.